house fires that were never proven, and there was a break in his home that hadn't been proven either. So a person that has no problem staging his own crime or event and then calling his insurance company.
And Dawson had recently made a call to the insurance company to sell the family's policies.
Julie Dawson's husband called a couple days after her disappearance, 2 days before she was found.
It's a $100,000 life insurance policy on Julia Dawson, and the beneficiary is her grieving husband, Tim. And it seems like Tim Dawson jumped the gun on trying to collect. Investigators are closing in on Tim Dawson, and they want to track his every move. Police attach a GPS to Tim Dawson's car, and for weeks, detectives are on
and
one of Dawson's most frequent destinations makes him look even more guilty.
We're able to then find a track in the house in the Grand Haven, Michigan.
And the house was an attack on the
here.
Police continue to track him as he breaks from his normal pattern.
He saw that the vehicle was we were able to get some
police continue to toss it his head aside. He crosses the border from Indiana, then Illinois. Dawson makes it all the way to Texas. The worst nightmare from the detectives launch a manhunt for Tim Dawson. The GPS near San Antonio. Tim Dawson.